Good morning, everyone. So I just landed in New Orleans and right now it's like pretty chill. I'm just relaxing here. Had a really good sleep, which was good because I was so scared that I wouldn't be able to fall asleep on the plane. 10:50. Oh, can't see. 10:50. And I'm just waiting for my cousin to arrive from Atlanta. And so he's going to be arriving in about actually like 30 minutes. So it's going to be pretty soon when I can see him. Hello, everyone. So we are at Acme Oyster House. And we are trying the oysters here, of course, because that's what they're famous for. And so I'll show you the shot of the oysters right now, and they look so good. I'm here with my cousin, Sunny. Hi, my travel buddy for the weekend. We're just gonna eat like so many meals, too many meals. And I just got a new Joby tripod, so you're gonna see that I can actually lift it up a lot higher now. Oh my god, this one's huge. So this is our crawfish po' boy. Then we've got the jambalaya! So, looks so good. Oh my god.
I had a bit of a nap. Unfortunately, I was a little bit too tired and I overslept. But right now we are at the best gumbo shop, and it's just called the Gumbo Shop, but I call it the best gumbo shop. And we are going to try, well, for me, I'm going to try my ever first, like, authentic Louisiana gumbo. And we've been given some complimentary bread, which is what I'm all about. So we're just going to try it. Oh, thank you for the complimentary bread. But look at this, guys. So this is the gumbo. Oh my god, that's so good. It just tastes like gravy. Very like spice gravy. And it has multiple veggies in it.
Try dipping your bread in it.
Oh my gosh, I can imagine it's going to taste so good. So yummy. This is just turning into a food vlog. Hello everyone. The lighting's a bit weird, but so it's our first night in New Orleans and we're just waiting for one of the jazz clubs called Fritzel's to open, and I think that they start at about 9 o'clock. And so right now we're just waiting for 30 more minutes ish before we start. And right now we have just had dinner. We're just walking around the city and honestly it's so amazing. It's surreal being here, and the like architecture, everything is just so cool. Oh my god. And it's just like got this like eerie feeling, which I absolutely love, because obviously, you know, New Orleans is really famous for their ghosts, their vampires, and also it's the filming place of The Originals, which is one of my favorite TV shows. So I don't know, got a feeling. Everyone, so it is currently, well, what time is it? It is currently 9:35 a.m. and it is a Saturday and it's our second day in New Orleans, and also unfortunately Sunny's last full day. So that's my cousin, by the way. And so say hi. And so we are heading to breakfast now. We just like did some drone flying, which is really really fun and a first time for me too, so that's like really cool. And yeah, we are going to a really famous spot called Café du Monde, and that is where they serve their famous beignets.
they do Monde, and right now, like, our food just came out, and I'm so sorry for my horrible skin, but because of traveling, it's not like the greatest right now. But anyway, so we ordered the only food that is on the menu, which is a beignet, and it is a pastry with white powder on top. And then I also ordered an iced Americano as usual, because it is so flipping hot here. Honestly, like, New York was almost 20 degrees colder than this. So yeah, I'm just getting ready to eat my beignet, so let's have a look. Okay, everything is like powdered with ice sugar here, and it's impossible to not get dirty. It's really hot. Okay, I'm sorry, Sunny, I'm gonna reach over you.
Okay. Use the tripod.
Oh my god, it's so good. It's like a donut, but in a square format. And a lot fluffier. It's so good. Definitely must try. New Orleans, like, by far is probably like one of the prettiest like cities slash like, well, cities slash countries, I guess, like, because it's on its own little country. Every street corner is music. Like, you can hear music from miles away. I don't even know what's playing, but you know, there's music. I'm just walking along. Oh, this bigger tripod is just so much easier to like get like a longer shot. It's great.
So this is the famous mother's ham, and this is really famous. We got french fries, we got cabbage, we got red beans on rice, but not the red beans on rice, what is this?
Green bean and tomato.
Green bean and tomato, and then there we've got our fried chicken, which is gonna be so good. I'm having the drum and Sunny is having pho. Very excited. What this hurricane drink. It's like what they're famous for in New Orleans, and it's like such a famous cocktail, but damn is it strong. It's like half rum, I'm pretty sure, and then
it looked like two-thirds to me.
Two-thirds rum and like one-third fruit juice. It's very, very intense. But look how pretty the color is.
The red?
But it's way too strong.
My boy Jay Wolf. Everybody show your love and make some noise for Jay Wolf. Come on, y'all. Watch it, y'all. Make it rain, make it rain, make it rain. Smack it, smack it.
everyone. So I just got back from the Preservation Hall concert. So if you don't know what the Preservation Hall is, it's like the most famous like spot to listen to jazz music in New Orleans. And I waited for 2 hours outside. Like originally I was gonna go to the 5 p.m. show. I arrived at 4:15 and you know what? I didn't get in because the line was so long. So I waited and waited for the 6 p.m. show, you know, whatever that gets me in, right? So I listened to it. There was no recording, unfortunately, but I'll insert a photo now of what it looked like. So you can see that it's pretty small. The jazz was absolutely amazing. You can tell how highly trained these musicians are. It's quite different to Fritzel's, which is what the European bar that I went to yesterday, European pub that I went to yesterday. And it was like, honestly, like the precision, like their tonality, the delicacy of how they play is so very New Orleans, but also like sort of like a higher escalated level of New Orleans jazz music. But it's funny because we are now in the, what's it called?
Old coffee pot.
And I'm about to eat buttermilk fried chicken, and outside is the line for Preservation Hall. So it's funny because the Preservation Hall is actually not the venue right next door. It's actually like two restaurants down. And so people are actually like lining up, and so they're probably going to be waiting here until the 9 p.m. show, to be really honest. Guys, look at our food. This is the buttermilk fried chicken. What did you get, Sonny?
Triple D.
It's got
green beans, shrimp, breasts of chicken, and then jambalaya.
Wow, so good. It looks really filling. And I've got the buttermilk chicken with the biscuit and the gravy. She looks so good. Lit. Good afternoon, everyone. So today we went and walked the French market. My cousin has officially left me, and I am now with my auntie and uncle. But how do you say hi?
Hi.
So today we are just like exploring New Orleans as well as going on a ghost tour. We are just like chilling and hanging. We just had beignets and of course had to have my second round. And so yeah, really excited to just chill out and about. And today it's really, really rainy. It's like storming as well, so not the best day, but it has given New Orleans a sort of ghost vibe, which is what I love. You be Sun Gang. That you suck.